Hello, everyone. This is from Milwaukee to Nashville, and I am Daniel Goodman. Over there is John Lewandowski, and we are from Milwaukee to Nashville, brought to you by the wonderful folks at Hockey Locker, 2002 West Hart Avenue, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. You can call them at 414-800-7585 or visit their website at hockeylockermilwaukee.com. Also, check out TNT Racing page as TNT Racing gets prepared for another race season as we aim to support them as they support us by putting our logo on their car every year. We do the same. So coming up for them, good a long race season. Something I am not ready for. All righty. So today the Atlanta Gladiators took on the Indy Fuel. The Indy Fuel are the ECHL team of the Bl Chicago Blackhawks. So we should be familiar with a couple of the guys possibly on this team. All righty.
All right. So shots on goal in the first period, Atlanta outshoots Indy 13-9. In the second period, Indy outshoots Atlanta 16-8. In the third period, Indy outshoots Atlanta 8-7. And in total, Indy outshoots Atlanta 33-28. Atlanta on the power play goes 0 for 6 with 12 minutes, 6 infractions, while Indy goes 1 for 5 with 14 minutes, 7 infractions. Scoring in the first period at the 5:28 mark for Indy is Colin Bilek, assisted by Mattis Spodniak and Brian Lemos. And at the 16:10 mark for Atlanta, Griffin Luce gets on the board, assisted by Reese Vitale and Michael Miller. Then in the second period at the 39 mark for Indy, Kyle Maksimovich scores, assisted by Cameron Hills and Santio Centrame. And at the 3:36 mark, Carson Gusevich scores for Atlanta. Then at the 5:23 mark for Indy, Cameron Hillis scores, assisted by Colin Bilek and Matthew Cairns.
All right, then scoring at the 6:09 mark was Brandon Hoffman for Atlanta with an assist from Robert Castilli and Jack Mateer. By the way, Griffin Luce, he is under contract with the Admirals, for those who wanted to know. And then we have Cam Baker scoring at the 8:02 mark with an assist from Brett Palmer and Zach Jordan. Zach Jordan was a player traded in that Wolves trade between the Wolves and the Ice Hogs. Then in the third at the 3:41 mark, Cameron Hillis scores with an assist from Ross McDougal. Then Brett Palmer scores for the Indy Fuel with an assist from Kyle Maksimovich and Ross McDougal. Then Reese Vitale scores at the 17:51 mark for Atlanta with an assist from Micah Miller. As it shows, Indy beats Atlanta 6-4.
6-4.
Statistics in net for the Indy Fuel was Zach Driscoll. He stopped a whopping 24 of 28 with an 85.7 save percentage. In net for Atlanta is Brad Brown. He stopped 27 of
27 of 33.
27 of 33. Okay, so he played the whole game. The crap list is Luke Prokop, Carson Gusevich, Jackson Pearson, Ryan Cranford, Griffin Luce, and Brad Brown and the coaching staff because they should not be giving up six goals this late in the year. All righty. So Atlanta falls again. At this point, it's looking like, yeah, they're in last place.
Yeah.
On a 5-game losing streak. They're 3-6-1 in their last 10. So they need to figure it out there in Atlanta. The Admirals today took on the Wolves, going for to tie their franchise record, consecutive wins, which is 13. The Wolves are coming in looking to upset the Admirals, as the Admirals have 1, 2, 3, 4. The Admirals have beat them in 1, 2, 3, 4 straight, and have a 5-1 record against them going into the season. So yeah, 5-1. So. Let's get into this real quick as I'm losing my voice.
All right. Shots on goal in the first period. Milwaukee outshoots Chicago 10-5. In the second period, Milwaukee outshoots Chicago 11-5. In the third period, Milwaukee outshoots Chicago 12-9. And in total, Milwaukee outshoots Chicago 33-19. On the power play, Chicago goes 1 for 6 with 27 minutes, 8 infractions, while Milwaukee goes 2 for 6 with 17 minutes, 7 infractions. Scoring in the first period, there was no scoring. Scoring in the second period at the 14:29 mark for the Admirals was Reed Schaefer scoring his third of the year, assisted by Fedor Svechkov, his 18th, and Spencer Stastny, his 13th. Then at the 19:31 mark for Chicago, Cole Schneider scores his sixth of the year on the power play, assisted by Corey Conacher, his 7th, and Ronan Seely, his 9th.
Scoring in the third at the 107 mark on the power play is Joachim Kebel, his 11th, with an assist from Igor Afanasyev, his 20th, and Jordan Gross, his 12th. Then Igor Afanasyev at the 19:51 mark scores his 21st on the power play on an empty net, with an assist from Mark Jankowski, Jayco getting his 32nd, and Stastny getting his 14th. The odd ball of the game, is that his? Okay. That makes me laugh. Now, did you get to hear the Cal O'Reilly penalty call
No.
from our side, like the arena side, when the arena called it?
No.
Okay, so when they called the Cal O'Reilly penalty, and they go, "Sir, penalty on Cal O'Reilly."
Yeah.
He's never there. He has 6 total penalty minutes this season, but he stays out of the box for most part.
Yeah.
So on that note, I honestly don't know what to say. We're on fire.
All right.
It's good to be back. I even told John the other day I had the itch. I'm like, come on, do something. Give me a reason. I even told him yesterday, like, there were rumors of trades, and we were like,
Yeah.
like, I wanna know, if it's a trade, we're putting it on camera,
All right.
because it's easier to break it down than to talk about it than make a graphic.
Yep.
It's true. We can look up all the stats and you can kind of get our live reaction to it, if you will. We are back tomorrow with a triple. Come on out to the Admirals game tomorrow. Cheap Trick post-game performance. Admirals going for a franchise record 14th straight win. Yarrow going for his 11th straight win if he starts. Grosnick going for his 13th straight win if he win if he plays. So lots of streaks on the hook. The Admirals also have not lost at home since December 9th. That's almost three. That's 2 months. Two, wait, three. Roughly 2 months.
Two, I think.
We're into February now. So, yeah, we haven't lost at home in a while. But no, well, I mean, the Admirals, the hottest team in sports right now. There's nobody that's got a streak like us. Ever since Edmonton's got snapped.
Yeah.
Right now, there's nobody hotter. Come on out and check us out. If you're in Nashville, go support the Preds. If you're in Atlanta, I don't know what Atlanta's got. If they're in Indiana or if they're in Atlanta. So that's a good question.
I believe in Indy.
I'm going to .com.com. Tomorrow's game is yes, it is in Indiana. So if you're in Indianapolis and you want to check out the Atlanta Gladiators, Indianapolis Fuel or Indy Fuel, whatever you want to particularly pertain to call them. With that being said, I'm going to go treat my vocals so that I can get prepared for tomorrow. John's going to get rest so he can prepare for tomorrow. We will be doing another virtual show tomorrow as it'll be very late because we are staying either for half or most of Cheap Trick's concert. So we'll be here probably about the same time tomorrow. So see you then.